Feature Friday.
The freshest.
This is like part 7 of this.
Literally, I think, is this part 4 or 5? I don't freaking know. But
hilarious.
More cute moments where kids, more K-pop idols being hilarious. So, let's go.
More little humans. Yes. With more big humans.
That's right.
That are famous. And charming.
He's so cute. This is fun, yes.
Well, you just keep doing that for half an hour. What
they
on
have,
earth are
you? I don't know, jump? What's so funny? Jumping. What?
You're trying. See you later, though.
High five himself.
Dude, that kid goes in the dark, he's never coming back. He dropped his ice cream. Oh, that's tough.
No. Oh, he's supposed to.
Oh, he's supposed
okay,
to.
I see.
Did I do it right?
Yeah, good job. Good job. Oh my god. That is so cute.
Can you repeat it one more time?
Has
it has seats everywhere.
A zebra. No.
That's a good game. Pause. Dude, look at that little human's haircut.
They're so cute.
That's sick. Nowadays, there's even competition in kids' fashion.
Oh, yeah.
Like, kids' fashion is a thing. That's a niche on Instagram, dude. Do you remember when all Instagram was filled out with cool kids? Like, these two-year-olds that didn't understand what Balenciaga was.
Repping the high
repping
fashion.
Balenci's.
Yeah. High fashion brands.
Clean, like they'd be wearing bucket hats and stuff, or they'd be wearing
cool,
like...
Looking cool? Cooler than me. Some of those two-year-olds were cooler than I ever aspired to be.
Dude, some of those, they had more drip than 99% of the population. Because also, young drip is very cheap drip.
No, it's not
cheap. Kid drip is so cheap.
Come on, how could you pay $50, $50 for a pair of shoes for a child that will outgrow them in literally 2 weeks?
Absolutely, but I'm not endorsing such behavior. Save your money, invest it.
Save for college, kids, or parents of kids.
But
if you have $50 to invest in a pair of shoes for a two-year-old, you probably can, you'll be fine with the college tuition.
It just looks funny. It looks like little keyrings or something. But again... But like you're $50, right? £50, for example, to get like a Balenciaga shoes for like a 1 year old little human, and then but the grown up ones are $320, so it is cheaper.
It is cheaper.
Yeah,
it's not cheap.
And then your kid is dripping. Why would you want your kid dripping? They don't even understand social.
They get dirty literally in 10 seconds after you put a nice pair of clothes on.
And neither should they. What would happen if that kids didn't evolve? Like kids just remain kids. Just their bodies grew, but like their concepts of society when as they are now. Maybe just add a bit of remorse and compassion.
I don't want to live in a world such like that. I want normal grown-up people to be around. I need to have normal grown-up
like,
conversations.
They'll just wear whatever they want, say whatever they want.
I can't talk about cocoons and butterflies for more than 15 minutes.
Yeah, tough. It will be a weird world if like grown-ups did believe Santa existed.
Wow.
That would be a strange world.
Well.
You know, actually, it would change the law as well. The idea of a foreign man with a beard coming down your chimney.
Not being seen as robbery and trespassing.
Concept of society would change automatically. But anyways, let's keep going with the cute...
the conversations that come out of these videos.
What? Just saying.
Yes.
Hide and seek.
God.
I used to hate that game when I was a kid.
Yes, Kai.
It made me feel dizzy as hell.
Oh my god, they're so cute.
Do it really fast so they throw up.
Aww.
Oh, I was about to say, is that Mini Jenny? Like...
Oh my god, how are they so good?
That's class.
I love the sped up version.
Wee. That's actually dope as hell.
What? Oh, he's so cute.
Acting silly. If Boogeyman is still around.
There's a Boogeyman,
there was
back,
a Boogeyman
in the day.
Back in the day. This door is scary looking. Whoa, man, what are you doing, bro?
It's Monster X. What do you expect?
Bad kids, one by... He took him one by one. That's evil.
You know what's
though?
Funny? Back home, what was it?
El Coco.
They used to tell
what's
you.
What's the one in Russia that John Wick is based on? They call it the Boogeyman, but it's called... oh, God. The one in John Wick is sick. It sounds amazing. It's like... Dorombra, dorombra. It's a wolf. You motherfuckers don't have to kids. Like, Jesus Christ.
You know
and
what's
el
funny?
Coco is such a weird idea, bro.
El Coco te va a salir del closet.
That means it's gonna come out. Actually, that's pretty self-explanatory. The closet.
It's gonna come out of your closet.
We stole that word from England.
That's very true.
Or English.
Yeah, and then the story was that if you didn't fall asleep early enough, like El Coco will come out and like haunt you in your dreams, pull your feet through underneath the covers, take you and separate you from your family forever. Whoa. Also, pretty scary though. For a child,
not really,
why would you tell that to your child?
Just the same.
But why were you scared your child into sleeping early? That is just so whiffed up.
Yeah.
And also, it
wasn't real. It wasn't real, no.
It wasn't real, me in my corner.
No, I would check and stuff. It wasn't real.
You know what's
like,
funny
it's just
also?
Just a saying, I found that out pretty early.
Well, the saying, there was also a saying that, like, my parents never did this stuff, like, my grandma either. But, like, I used to, like, whenever you hanged out with your friends that were wrongly behaved outside, their parents would always look at them and say, like, you see that man walking over there? I'm gonna tell him to come over and steal you.
Ooh, bro!
That one was scary.
Is that actually what? Damn,
yeah,
bro.
I remember. And it turns out that a lot of parents did that to their kids. And I used to come home all scared, telling my mom, I think you need to call child security.
Damn, bro.
Child services.
That's heavy shit, man. Damn.
It was very funny. Latino culture is ruthless. Like, La Llorona.
Yeah, when it comes to, like, scary stuff, we do have some really
disturbing things that you tell your kids.
And in primary school, I had to reenact some of them because they're folklore.
It's part of the culture, yes.
Yeah.
But why would you tell that to your kids?
I don't know, but it was fucking hilarious.
It's weird. Why would you scare your kids into behaving?
And it's not the same here, actually. Is it the same in Europe? It certainly isn't the same in London. Like you don't
least not in England.
You don't make kids here reenact, like, Hail Mary.
That's true.
Then, you know, the Bloody Mary, whatever it is. Bloody Mary, and then you're dead or something. Or, like, itty bitty spider, you get poisoned. Is that
I don't know. You're making that up.
Yeah, you don't do that here.
Yeah, but back home,
because it's so part of the folklore of the country.
You
we
actually
do it.
Have to.
I had to reenact. What was it? El Achador Sin Cabeza?
Yeah.
Something like that. Something like that, right?
Hollow Man with an axe.
Yeah, Hollow Man.
It's basically literal translation to that. And that's the whole story. And it's not the hollow thing. It's not the guy that he's like, he rides.
It's not Hiccupus. Icabus.
Not very familiar with stuff, because we obviously had our own back home.
Yeah, we made our own versions of that.
I wonder where the inspiration came from. But yeah, and we sort of had to reenact it, and it was horrendous. Like, I was a killer.
Literally, I had nightmares. Like, in third grade, my teacher made me read stories out loud. It was part of, like, the syllabus the language, like Spanish, the language as a subject. It will make you read these, like, stories.
It's literature.
That
it's literature. The country's literature. Yeah.
And it's, like, it was so rich in literature, but it was super scary. And I was, like, 8 years old, and I was coming home.
It's scary for 8 years old. Like, you hear it right now. It's, like creepypasta type of thing. Creepypasta?
Pasta?
Isn't that what it is?
What?
Creepypasta? Isn't that a thing?
You're talking about the Italian dish,
bro,
pasta?
Creepy pastas. That used to be a thing, no? Like a YouTube channel type of thing where they would tell, like, stuff. Creepy. Creepy pasta. Dude, you make me doubt. I hate this fucking place.
I'm done.
Oh my
Get
god.
Get me out of here.
Yeah.
What is that?
Creepy pastas.
Oh, he's live right now.
Oh, do you watch a live?
No.
I hate this stuff. I don't like it.
Creeps me out for real.
But it's like stories of, like, scary stuff. And then, like, the same as American Horror Stories, you know, that type of, like, it was shows where they would tell, like, but they were more, like, stories that could be real, but these are actual, like, entities or ghosts.
Fabulas.
It's the same in English. I don't know what it's in English.
But it was all about the spirits, and back home it's like, really deeply rooted in the country.
You tell kids, if you don't behave, one of them
the spirits are going to come take you. And people would actually tell you stories of them being taken by the spirit.
Yeah, that's not a word in English.
Spirit.
Tomato.
Anyways, carrying on with this, what the hell?